with longitude is related to twilight. Twilight is a very popular phenomena. It is atmospheric phenomena seen before sunrise and after sunset. It is very dim light caused due to diffusion by the atmospheric dust. What is twilight? Its definition is written here that it is light seen before the sunrise and after the sunset. And how twilight occurs? This is the figure, this is sun and this is the earth. Sun is giving insulation to the earth and this earth is rotating on its axis in anti-clockwise way. And here it is written North Pole. North Pole should have been written here, but why it has been written here, this thing should be known. And this figure is the picture taken in this mode. This is the globe. If you take picture from this side, then in the center of this globe, this North Pole will be located. So this is the North Pole, and if you will locate North Pole here, so within 6 hours, according to the rotation of the earth, this North Pole will be here just below the sun. Sun rays will become vertical and all the ice of North Pole will melt. But it is North Pole, this is the equator, and in equatorial region you are seeing that sun rays are seen here. This is the night part of the earth, this is day part. Just after night, here the point will notice, it will observe the sun rays. So here it will be morning. But before morning, here some light will be seen, that is called twilight. How this twilight will be seen? Sun rays coming in this way will be collided with the dust particle in this atmosphere, and due to it their diffusion process will take place, and this diffused light will reach here. Its intensity will be much in sector 1, then less sector 2, then least in sector 3. What is 1, 2 and 3? Actually, this is civil twilight, this is nautical twilight, and this third one is astronomical twilight. Twilights on the basis of intensity are of 3 types. Civil twilight means before 6 degree angle. So angle is formed here, and 6 degree before means 24 minutes before. If before seeing the sun in the morning, if someone arises or leaves bed, this is called civil twilight, and he is authorized to be called civilian of that country. And 12 degree before, it is nautical twilight. Mariners leave their bed and they go for the journey in oceans, fishing or any. And 18 degree before, it is very dim light, that is called nautical twilight. Astronomers wake up in this time and do their work. They make astronomical observations. Why? Because during this time, during this twilight of 18 degree, this atmosphere is nearly dustless, because after midnight this part of night becomes cool and most of the dust particles settle down. That's why astronomers observe the galaxies, the planets and satellites with their instruments to gauge the stars. So this is the twilight in the morning. In the same way, there is evening twilight. Why? because here this is day part, and after the sunset, after the last visit of this sun rays, when sunset is there, then it is evening twilight, and the light comes here. Dust particles are there in abundance. In comparison to morning twilight, in evening twilight, dust particles are more. That's why twilight is more intense and it is seen. The angles are the same as they were in the morning. So this way, we have noted that three twilights, one is civil twilight at 6 degree angle, means 24 minutes before the sunrise. Nautical twilight means 12 degree angle, that we have noticed here, are 48 minutes before the sunrise. And astronomical twilight, 18 degree angle, are 72 minutes before the sunrise. Now let us understand what are the causes of twilight. So the cause of twilight is actually the movement or motion of the subsolar point. Suppose this is the earth and sun is here. The sun rays are not vertical on the entire earth at a particular moment. At a particular moment, the sun rays will be vertical at a certain point of the earth. That is called subsolar point. And subsolar point is not fixed. Due to rotation of the earth, the subsolar point also moves. Because the earth is rotating on its axis in anti-clockwise way, that's why the subsolar point moves on the earth in clockwise way. Accordingly, the twilight also moves on the earth in clockwise direction. It may be morning twilight, suppose sun is here, it may be morning twilight, it may be evening twilight. Both will move in a clockwise way. Now the question is there that whether the twilight will move very fast along equator or on pole. The answer is that the twilight moves at fastest rate along the equator. Why? Because the equatorial point completes a complete cycle in 24 hours. In the same way, the point on Arctic Circle also takes 24 hours to make one rotation. This way, 24 hours duration is the same, but the distance covered by the two points differs. That's why the equatorial point has to travel more distance in comparison to Arctic Circle. That's why twilights move at the fastest rate along the equator. So fast that in some books it has been written that there is no twilight along the equator. But it is not so. There is twilight, but it is so fast that it cannot be observed. As we move northward towards North Pole and South Pole, the motion rate of the twilight decreases, and at both the poles, twilight seems stationary. So, this is about the movement of twilight. One thing more, that here the question is there that whether duration of this twilight should be counted in day or in night. So its answer is very much clear, because in newspaper we count day from the sunrise point to the sunset point, and the twilight is actually the part of night, and this is in Hindi called Sandhya Vela. There are two types of Sandhya. This is morning and this is evening. And it is advisable for people to rise up early in the morning for fresh air, because during day hours The atmosphere is full of pollutions, dust and aerosols. Just after sunset, it gradually settles down, and after midnight, the sky is completely clear of pollutions and dust. Only fresh oxygen is found, that is in Hindi called pranavayu. So for pranavayu, we should leave orbit early in the morning, means in the twilight, and complete our routine work, become fresh, and then we start our work. One question also arises that what should be done to remove twilight from this earth? Only one way, that if we sweep our atmosphere, the dust, gas and vapor from the atmosphere swept away, then there will be no twilight. There will be direct sunrise and sunset. Sunrise means it is night, complete dark night, and sun will be seen suddenly. There will be no problem. But in the evening, there may be problem, because just after sunset, it will seem that light has gone, bulb now not working. That's why it may create problem to civilians. That's why thanks God Almighty, our nature, who has thrown or scattered dust particles, vapor and all the things in atmosphere, and that gives us twilight for our welfare and for our facility. So this is about the twilight.